we are going to discuss chapter 7 of science of class 4, and the topic of chapter 7 is the clothes we wear. So students, long time ago when early man used to live in caves, he covered his body with, they were not having clothes, so how they cover? They cover their body with leaves, bark of trees and animals skin. Men gradually learned the art of weaving cloth, followed by stitching it into garments. Clothes are an important part of our lives now. We wear clothes for protection from weather, dust and germs. Clothes also make us look smart. We live in a civilized society and wear different types of clothes suitable for the work we do and the climate we live in. Now the next topic is choice of clothes. It is now the clothes based on weather. People wear different clothes in different weather condition. In hot weather, people wear clothes that help to keep body cool and dry. We wear cotton clothes in this weather condition. And cotton clothes are best for summer because they easily absorb the sweat. People also wear light color clothes in this weather that reflects the heat. In cold places, people wear woolen clothes to protect themselves from cold. You must have noticed the people living in hilly areas. They wear layers of woolen clothes that shield their bodies from the chilling weather. The warm air is trapped between the layers of these woolen clothes. During rainy season, raincoats made up of waterproof material are used for protection from the rain. Now next, clothes based on nationality or tradition. Clothes are also worn as per the culture and tradition of a country. Many countries in the world consider some dresses in their national or traditional dresses. For example, sari is the traditional dress of Indian women. Yes, it is the traditional dress of Indian women. Kimono is the traditional dress of Japanese women. And hanfu is the traditional dress of China. Hanfu is the traditional dress of China. Now, clothes based on profession. You must have seen people are wearing different types of clothes. Doctor and nurses in the hospital wearing white coats. Factory workers wear overalls which cover their whole bodies. A soldier also wear a particular uniform. Therefore, we see that some clothes define the profession of different people. Different fabrics are used in different types of clothes. Now the next topic is cloth materials. Different materials for making clothes are obtained from natural or synthetic sources. Natural fibers like cotton, linen, jute, silk and wool are obtained from natural sources like plants and animals. From where we get these material? We get these material from plants and animals. Cotton is obtained from cotton plant. Linen is obtained from flax plants, whereas silk is obtained from the cocoons of silkworms. We get wool from the hair of animals like sheep, camels and goats. Fibers prepared artificially are called synthetic fibers or man-made fibers. For example, nylon, rayon and polyester. They are also known as man-made fibers. Clothes made from synthetic fibers are stronger than the clothes made from natural fibers. They have extraordinary qualities of quick drying and flexibility. These are also wrinkle-free. But these clothes do not absorb sweat or allow body heat to escape. So these clothes are not very suitable for hot and humid climate. Natural and synthetic fibers have to go through various stages to be woven into fabrics. So the next topic is fiber to fabric. There are three steps to make fabric from fibers. First is making yarn. The raw fiber from cotton, silk, wool and or the synthetic sources is twisted to make thread or yarn. This is called spinning. Earlier, charkha was used for spinning in our country, which was then replaced by machines called spinning jenny. Nowadays, spinning is done on very sophisticated machines in textile mills. Now, next topic is making fabrics. The second step is weaving, in which the thread or yarn is made or woven into fabric. This is done on looms by hand and by machines in mills. In the hand loom, the long threads are crisscrossed to weave them into fabric. However, these days most of the fabric is made on machinized or power looms. Next is finishing of fabric. The third and almost final step of making fabric is dyeing and printing. Dyeing is the process by which a fabric is given color. By dyeing, we are going to give color to the fabric, and printing gives the desirable design and pattern to the fabric to make it stylish and attractive. Let us now learn how to take care of our clothes. Care for clothes. Next topic is care for clothes. The first step is clothes get dirty after wearing due to sweat, dirt and stain. We must wash our clothes regularly in clean water with soap or detergent. Secondly, we must also take care that all the soap or detergent in the clothes is washed out completely, otherwise clothes turn yellowish after ironing. Third step, white clothes can be soaked in indigo powder, commonly known as neem, and then dried in the sun. Fourth step, after the clothes are dried, we should iron them. Iron clothes make a person look tidy and smart. And silk and woolen clothes need gentle washing or dry cleaning. Now the next topic is how to prolong the life of clothes. Clothes hold an important place in our lives and need to be stored safely. Rats and certain insects like silverfish and moths harm the clothes. They attack and eat the clothes made from natural fibers like silk and wool. These clothes need special care in a safe and dry place which is free from insects and rats. Naphthalene balls and dried neem leaves can be used to keep within folds of clothes while storing to keep away these insects. Woolen and silk clothes should be dried completely in sun before storing. Clothes look nice and last longer if we take proper care of them. Now, quickly we recap what we have read in this chapter. Clothes protect us from extreme weather, insects and dirt. The choice of clothes depend upon the climate, tradition and occupation. Clothes are made from natural as well as from synthetic material. Spinning, weaving, dyeing and printing are different steps to make fabric from fiber. Proper cleaning and ironing of clothes make them look nice and last longer. And clothes should be stored properly to prolong their life. I hope everybody has understood what I have explained. PDF we will send you, so you have to do question answers in the copy and exercise in the book. Thank you.